Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. We're here today with Wayne Sutton, who is running for Royal Oak City Commission. How are you today?
Doing great, thanks.
Well, thanks for being here. Can you just tell us why have you decided to run for the commission?
Yeah, this is my first time getting involved in local government. And it's one of those things where my wife and I were talking, and it was kind of like, you know, we love Royal Oak. Maybe we should get more involved. You know, I see a lot of people shaking their fist at the TV, and those issues are just way above our pay grade. And so it's like, let's get involved with the local government and see what we can do, because that's where you can really have the most impact. And a lot of people don't recognize that, you know, the local issues are the ones that really impact you day to day. And so we're getting involved.
So what are some of those things you'd like to work on?
Yeah, one of the big issues that I was unaware of before I got involved was the master plan, which is a really amazing document. This is one of those foundational plans that allow for investment and that set the blueprint that a lot of other elements of the city are built upon. So that would include things like, what is the vision for downtown? What about our streets? How do we attract businesses and residents that are attractive? And that stuff doesn't happen by accident. And the current master plan, this is a 25-year document. And it becomes kind of like the Constitution. Like, once it's set, changing it is quite difficult. And it's an important document. The current one's like over 200 pages long. Like, it outlines a lot of detail. The reason that's important is that document will get, it's being currently drafted, and there's a draft in play. And there's some language in there that I found pretty ambiguous and opened up the door to some things that I'm like, there should be some more representation and input on that. And because of that, things like zoning are important. Single family residents are important, because as a homeowner and in the community, that's a big investment. That's something that you would want to be involved in and say, have some input. And when I talk about input, that was part of the reason I got involved as well, is I've personally felt pretty dismissed going to the charrettes or some of the neighborhood issues. And it was like, the police officers were like, well, you should get involved. And it's like, well, yeah, maybe I should, instead of going to next door and being a digital warrior. It's like, put in some time and do it. So the master plan is important. And then another one that I think is important is the business side of the city. Everything takes money, and making sure that the taxpayers' money is spent really responsibly and transparently. What I mean by that is not everyone's going to be happy. Like, you can't get 60,000 people to agree on the priorities for everything, but at least there should be a record. There should be a process. Contracts should be bid competitively to make sure we're getting the best product and prices. So those are some of the big issues that are inspired me to get involved.
Can you tell us a bit about your professional background and the skills you bring to the table?
Yeah. So a couple of things that I've been involved in commercial banking was where I started my career. And from there, I went into education and training. So that's where I got involved with public speaking. It's something I enjoy doing. And from there, I went in and got my MBA, which brought more of that academic and financial acumen to a front. And then I specialized in organizational change management. And that's how I came out here to Detroit, working for some of the big automotive suppliers. And most recently, being at a large multinational management consulting firm. So going in and leading organizational change. And the reason that is really important to the role of a city commissioner is you're asking people to collaborate, to understand the urgency if we do or don't do something. What is the vision? What does success look like? Who's on the team? What's the representation? How do we reinforce the process? And that takes a lot of awareness, because like any group of people, getting people aligned and working in the same direction in the best interest, where you may not get everything you want. So that's where my professional background of change management and a business acumen really will support the role of a city commissioner.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
I haven't been that involved. It's my wife's in the PTA. I'm a father of two. My oldest daughter's off to college. My youngest one is at Royal Oak Middle School. So it's been more of a grassroots kind of thing, talking with neighbors. A group of people are like, "Hey, I like what you're saying, Wade." And I sympathized with some of the challenges that they had brought up and came with an open mind to try and solve some of these things. And that brings up an experience that I had just this week. So the Downtown Development Authority had a community listening event at Bamboo. And it was kind of a open house where they had several proposals, like what should we do on Fifth Avenue for the open air area. And one of the patrons there, talking about, "Hey, I'm going to be, I'm on the ballot in November." They're like, "Well, what are you going to do to change things in Royal Oak?" And my first response was, "There's a lot of good things happening. I like downtown." But I didn't have a nuanced answer. And then I went to dinner at Luigi's. And Luigi, the owner of the restaurant, little Italian spot, right there by Fifth Avenue, came and sat down with us. And he's been in Royal Oak for decades. And he had ideas, he had opinions, he had things that, and that's the point. Like, as a city commissioner, yes, I have ideas, but my ideas may not be the best ones, and I doubt they would be. My role in involvement is to get the right people in the room, ask questions, and see. I mean, Luigi has sat and stared out his window for 20 years. Like, he has the pulse on that downtown area. Like, what brings people to your restaurant? Why are people not coming to your restaurant? He sits and talks to people that are more intimate with that. My community involvement is getting started, but I feel like I can ask the right questions and include more representation.
In this race, there are a few people running for these seats. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, first of all, out of all the people in the community, to have six people raise their hand as city commissioners, they're all genuine people that want to help the city. So I'm excited that at least we have a choice. Some races just run unopposed. So that the community has a choice is a bonus. So I'm glad that there's other people willing to step up and support. That being said, I want to win and I would love to have your vote. And so the reason I think I would be a great candidate is that I'm in it to have a good time. I'm really just trying to help out. I know it's pretty rare that anybody goes to a city planning meeting or a city commission meeting and is like, "I just wanted to use my 3 minutes to say thank you." So I recognize there's going to be some challenges, but for me, I'm looking to support the community, ask good questions, and just be as sincere as I can.
If the voters want to know more about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Number one, you can go to my website, Elect Wade 2023. That has my email address on it. It has my phone number on it, and also a donate button. This has been super grassroots. I've literally called every person that has donated to my campaign on the website. I've picked up the phone and called them because there's just been so few. Like, we are printing flyers and putting up yard signs. Go to the website. Send me an email, give me a call. We look forward to hearing from you.
Perfect. Well, thank you for taking the time to talk with us today.
Thanks, Crystal. I appreciate your time.